I have always felt that we have missed the point, intellectually speaking. If we try to imagine ourselves as being very small, everything that has to do with us becomes insignificant. And perhaps we can rediscover a poetic dimension about life. Everything else is mysterious and infinite.
Analyst of the human condition, Soravia does not have a dramatic vision, but rather the image of an individual situation that obliterates all social, generational, ethnic, or other differences. His work is a knowledgeable accusation against the exasperated individualism of our times, which has become an indiscriminate endemic phenomenon. For Soravia, whether humans gather together in armies or wander desolately around the world, they are always alone. They march in tight formations aimlessly. They move without purpose. Each individual is separated from his companion by his own incapacity to communicate. And yet the masses utilize efficient social organizations and associations that the artist symbolizes with elegant cylinders, pyramids, cubes, and cones. The reassuring forms of perfect geometric solids supporting the groups of figures that seem to be ordered into well-defined marching positions, but which return to tread over their same steps, invariably, uselessly. Few artists have such great ability to exemplify the human condition so peacefully, without emphasis, but with a sense of understanding and participation that is totally vibrant and alive. Few possess the same essentialness and poverty that is used to just as convincingly arrange the information of an analysis, which, though skeptical, shows no sign of rhetoric or moralism. Yet it should be pointed out that essentiality and poverty of technical devices are a determining conceptual factor in Soravia's poetic expression. In fact, he conceals his skill. It is enough just to think about the miraculous manual dexterity involved in creating the precise and expressive world of his 2-centimeter men. This indeed offers insight into the incredible expert miniature execution by Soravia. The fact that his universe is expressed in miniature, though his images are not Lilliputian at all, reduces the emphasis from the themes and feelings, which in reality, if not dramatic, are apocalyptic and profoundly moving, and which from a few centimeters away already appear minimal and negligible, but which instead may invoke epic and tragic emotions. It is similar to a war of ants, which while lying on a field, we chance to discover and observe while the conflict unfolds. Perhaps Soravia wants to show how, before nature, the enormous tragedies of the masses or the existential dramas of the individual have the same importance or none at all. Nature is indifferent to one or the other. But work that is deliberately created on a miniature level may also indicate the intention to play down the artistic gesture, to bring it back to its original artisan roots, to remove the sacredness of the aesthetic language, to find an intimate, ritual, profoundly subjective reason, to eliminate the stentorian and, referring to plastic language, to deny sculpture that monumentalistic structural damnation. Beyond any other evaluation, we must acknowledge the fact that Soravia is a unique, solitary, untrendy artist who creates grandiose works on a miniature scale. But he is also a melancholy narrator of solitary recitations in deserted theatres, the singer of the silent flights by seagulls, the evoker who bitterly enjoys human behaviour and gestures, silence and deafness. And from these unfathomable distances which separate human beings, the artist highlights the contradictions, the separateness, and the passive acceptance of the standardization of the individual that lead man to sadly consider how the numeric progression among the inhabitants of the planet and the technological success increase his loneliness, a never-ending conflict against the environment and his peers. A sculptor and ceramist, Soravia has always had a particular feeling for colour that is different from most of the modelling artists. And this is why he also creates other works as a painter. His paintings exist independently, while also maintaining the symbolic similitude and the poetic aura of his ceramics and sculptures. The metaphysical atmosphere in the paintings is more and more accentuated and is explicitly declared with its unmistakable silent melancholy. And the parables of the miniature man mass become sweeter in the presence of the grandeur of nature. Here it can be seen quite clearly how, all things considered, Soravia's intentions are not moralistic, but that he prefers to describe his own choice, with vibrant congeniality, to remain close to this small man, to those minuscule unknowing armies, or to be amazed by the clear appearance of a tree, the dazzling magnificence of a sun, under which it is possible to organize a ring-a-ring of roses and be happy without being anyone special.
The day has come to an end. Today I also tried to learn something, to understand. But the truth is always beyond the horizon, beyond this sea, so beautiful, so indifferent.